Hello everybody, this
Hello.
Is Minnie. My name is Coco, and today we're going to talk about breast cancer awareness because October is Breast Cancer Awareness Day, and we both have stories to tell about it. I'm going to go first because mine is less scary than hers. So I have relatives from both sides that have been diagnosed with breast cancer. They both got mastectomy, so that has always been like kind of in the back of my mind. I'm like I know how genetics work, like the risk is pretty high, and my boobs are like big, and then my mom's boobs were not big when she was my age, so I was like, oh, this is like not normal. There's always just been like this rational fear. So this summer I finally got them checked out like online. It was reasonably priced. It's very nice, like very clean, and it's very systematic. And when you go, if you tell them like what you're there for, blah, 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 they will direct you to the right place, and it's pretty fast too. So what they did was they got an ultrasound of both of my breasts. It was a male doctor though, and I think that's the only one that's available there. My results came out. The doctor, while he was like checking my breasts, he just told me like, oh, there are no lumps, blah, blah, everything looks normal. And he showed me how to check them. And then they gave me like a CD with like all of the images, and that was over in like less than 2 hours. Like, I want to say around an hour.
So it was like, I believe back in like 8th or 9th grade, pretty early on, one day I felt a lump on my breast and I was like, hey, what's this? And my mom's like, well, you should get that checked out. So we went to the doctor, and because I would also say like Myanmar doesn't have the best like healthcare system,
it doesn't.
Or any like doctor specialty, any like system,
especially since that was 4 or maybe 5
yeah,
years ago.
And because a political change hasn't occurred. Back to the whole story, I went to get it checked out, and the doctor was like, well, the procedure is, if there's a lump on your breast, you need to get it out. They took a blood test, they took all these like crazy tests, most of which I don't remember. I had to also get a mammogram, and because I was so young, it just haunted me. Like, I was with women who were like 40, 50, like trying to get all these mammograms. And I was with them, like, I was what, 15?
13.
Yeah, I mean, this is insane. And then, so I'd already set my surgery date in Myanmar. So they had already decided that I needed surgery. Like, this was the only way. So here I was, not necessarily a developed woman yet, going through surgery unnecessarily. We'll be going through surgery. Because my family was lucky enough to have the financial capacity, we flew to Malaysia, and the doctor right away was like, okay, you, at the age of 13, do not need to be getting mammograms, because you are still not fully developed. And I was like, okay. And she diagnosed me, took some tests, and she says that it was swelling of my lymph node. So I guess it just goes to show that, like, a lump on your breast, you should be aware of it, but it doesn't always mean, this is something I need surgery or something at. It was just the swelling of a lymph node, and I got like 2 weeks dose of antibiotics. Then within 2 weeks, it was over. Like, there were no more lumps on my breast, and I was no longer like scared of potentially getting cancer or like having a scar on my breast forever.
The doctor teach you how to like perform self-exams?
The one
in Myanmar or the one in Malaysia?
The one in Malaysia taught me how to do it. The one in Myanmar really wanted to like just jump to conclusions and like just get...
She just wanted to
just do the surgery.
Yeah.
And I kept asking throughout it all, like I remember just asking, why does it happen? Because I wanted to know like how to prevent it, you know? I was like, so why did my lymph node swell up? Why am I getting a lump in my breast? And everyone was just like, well, there's no answer to that, it just happened. So I guess like it just goes to show, it's not your fault, there was nothing you could do to prevent it. Being aware of it when it happens, like that's what's important.
The doctor that I had was very informative, even though it was weird that like he was male, but then like he was very professional. There was a nurse and my mom was in the room, even though I felt more uncomfortable about my mom being in the room than anyone else being in the room. And the doctor taught me like how to perform, and he differentiated between lymph nodes, which are like near your armpit area, so it's easy to be like boobs. So that's our story. Like, do you have anything else to say?
Be always aware of like what's happening to your body, and that know that if something were to go wrong, like that it's not your fault, and do what you can to be like to gather information and to help other women know how to perform tests and just support each other.
Yeah, there's a lot of YouTube videos on like how to do self exams. The reason I'm making this video and I'm like bringing Minnie is because it is October, so it's Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and it's also her birth month, and we're in the corner right now. It's so awesome. Oh my god. There's a lot of information about where you can get these, blah, 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 in the States or in like other places, but there's not a lot about this type of information in Myanmar, so I'm just like hoping to like get that out. And if you guys have any questions about it, you can ask me, or you can ask me and then I'll ask Nini about it if I don't know. Yeah, leave questions down below.
Let's promote awareness together. Goodbye.
Bye.
Oh,
it's like this.
Oh my god.